whose race are put together. Diversity, remember? If you diversify in terms of poverty data, what's going to happen? Everything changes. State QB funding. I'm coming back to that. Equalization funding. Carl Vinson's study itself on page 31, I believe it is, identifies that there'll be a loss of equalization money. A substantial loss of equalization money because in 2008, both systems projected to have received $12 million in equalization money. This past year, both systems combined received $4.5 million in equalization money. The Lowndes County School System alone in the last 10 years, their teachers and students have earned $25 million plus that the state didn't send to them. Guess who got to pick up that tab? Because the children still come to school every day, right? Let's look at the other ones. New schools, salaries, teachers, administrators, and support staff. There will be a reduction in teachers. There will be a reduction in administrators. There will be a reduction in support staff, particularly central office support staff. I think it's page 32 of Carl Vinson's study begins to talk about QBE and QBE ranges and how it's funded. A 10,000 student school system, FTE system, or a 17.5 FTE system. I just consolidated it, by the way. Did y'all see that? They earn a similar range of money for central office support. So the money currently being earned by Valdosta City Schools when they become non-independent will no longer come to Lowndes County School System. You'll lose that money. You'll lose, so you're going to lose expenses, right? If people are being paid with that money, I've already created a puzzle up here that says we don't have enough money. Let's go to the next slide now. I don't want to hog the time. Let's see who is affected and how would consolidation affect my personal finances. Let's talk about who. How about a homeowner, a property owner? Maybe you're saying, well, I rent. Maybe a renter, a business owner, a citizen, and our children. The children, the future of our community. I used to tell teachers in old faculty lounges where you had to fight the smoke. They'd be in there complaining. I said, listen, if you don't want to do this job right but for one other reason, you're going to turn over one day. Somebody's going to have to take care of you medically. Somebody's going to have to take care of your finances. And somebody's going to have to make sure you live from point A to point B, get from point A to point B. So if you don't care for no other reason, make sure that you educate these children right and take care of you. And boy, you're talking about getting out there and putting the cigarettes out and putting Coca-Colas in the trash. But our children's future is about this, y'all. If we're going to set 21 meals as the new standard, who's going to pay? Let's go to the next slide. This is a